Good afternoon to all viewers. Hope you would have enjoyed a very good lunch. This is the final session of today's panel discussion on Atmanirbhar Bharat, Make in India. The last session will be handled by our own alumni, Mr. P. Arulmani of Automobile Department, who is now an entrepreneur having his own startup called Palanivel Pyros. And he is working on a very good project of generating alternate fuels from waste plastics. That is a wonderful project what he is carrying out right now. We are very proud to invite Mr. P. Arulmani for delivering this session. I thank him for accepting our invitation. And now I am handing over the session to Mr. P. Arulmani. He is now in person, right now available in the college. He will be handling the session.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am privileged to introduce myself, Arulmani, as an alumni of VMKV Engineering College from Automobile Department. I have completed my course last year, 2020, and I am extremely thankful to our principal and management of VMKVEC who had mentored and helped me in the various stages of the startup. During my final year, a group of 8 members have came with an idea of alternate fuel to produce from the waste plastics as our last year project also. Through that, we have developed a machine which can able to manufacture alternate fuel from all kind of organic and inorganic plastics and other manures. And then finally, we have chosen the plastic because it is a byproduct of petroleum products, which can give us higher yield in producing petroleum fuels and waste products. Okay. Let's see what our project it is. This is the source. Our traditional fuel, petroleum, have been developed from the crude oil, but our project is based on waste plastic cum petroleum products. And in this method, we have induced the thermal cracking method to reprocess the plastic and wastes. Through this, we can get a high enriched petroleum fuels as well as carbon products. In this method, we have developed a unique machine which can be produce a fuel without any emission in this process. Let's see the pictures of those machines. This is the schematic diagram of the machine, which has a furnace and a reactor, two column condensers and a reservoirs, a fractional distillation column. The furnace, which able to produce a heat up to 700 degrees centigrade. Through that, the plastic can be pyrolyzed in the reactor. The pyrolyzed plastic vapors sent through the fractional column where the catalyst is added. The catalyst is zeolite, which can able to crack the polymers chains and convert the vapors into valuable fuels. In the first condenser, we can able to reduce the temperature from 150 degrees centigrade to 110 degrees centigrade, which is the diesel fractionation. Then it is collected in the first reservoir. Then the remaining vapors, it is sent through the second condenser, where it reduces the temperature from 110 degrees centigrade to 90 degrees centigrade, which is called the petroleum fractionalization. In this form, we can obtain the gasoline liquid in a pure grade of a density 810 kilogram per meter cube. Then the remaining fumes, it is passed through the non-condensable pipes and get to the furnace to heat it up. Through this process, we can manufacture high-grade diesel and petroleum fuels which does not produce any sulfur content in it. So the fuel used in the vehicle also does not produce any emission like NOx, carbon monoxide, excessively from the fossil fuels. The fuel can be used in all kind of automobile engines and industrial evaporators, furnace, boilers, kilns, and etc. The project involved in the conversion of all kind of industrial plastic wastes into synthetic fuels without causing any pollution in manufacturing them. All kind of automobile sector and industrial sector can be benefited through this project. Now we have developed a 110 pyrolysis plant and successfully erected in our own locality, Omlur, where we are able to produce up to 800 liters per day, and we are now selling this to the local available customers and transporters. Okay. Now I am going to explain the struggles and hurdles faced when I am going to start a own startup through this project. First of all, for this project, we need a huge landmass which do not cover the any rural areas. It should be very away from any houses or any other commercial resorts like that. So we have chosen a very vast area in a long village, and then for that we need to get the permission from Tahsildar, VAOs and BDOs. Then next, after that, we need to get a pollution certificate from Pollution Control Board. Then we need to get a plan approval for the company. So that I had approached the BDO, then I got the building approval, and then Then next, gone for the emission control board permission, where this company is registered as red category because it creates much pollution from its exhaust. So that we had developed an unique SCR converter which reduces the excessive NOx and CO2 emissions. So right now we are able to get the permission from red category to green category. And then next, it is registered under for a small business category, SME, which is able to operate without any restrictions from the local bodies. Okay, let's see what are the raw materials we are using here. The basic raw materials are plastic, combinations like HDPE, LDPE, polystyrene, polyesterene, polyvinyl chloride, and ABS plastics. In this process, we can able to get up to 75% oil yield from 1 kilogram of plastics. While we are able to manufacture 1 ton of pyrolysis unit, we can get up to 800 liters from 1,000 kilogram of plastics with the addition of catalyst. The catalyst is uniquely developed from our college. It is called zeolite, which is a combination of crystalline amorphous now can you anyone please tell me about the hazards of plastics we are using right now?
Participants, raise your hand so that you can unmute the audio. Can you people tell about the hazards of plastics? See, he is alumni of our college, so that if you interact, it will be good enough and we can have a lively webinar. Anyone raise your hand? You people doesn't know about the hazards of plastics?
Okay, my dear brothers and sisters, யாராவது ஒருத்தர் ப்ளீஸ் நம்ம யூஸ் பண்ணுற அன்றாட வாழ்வியல் நெகிழியில் என்னென்ன எமிஷன்ஸ் வருது அப்படின்னு யாராச்சும் சொல்கிறீங்களா? Okay, I will explain it. It emits NOx, nitrous of oxides, CO2 and carbon monoxides and ozone depleting gases, etc. So through this process, we can emit all these kind of gases by pyrolyzing the plastic. It can be arrested and reduced by the SCR we have used in this system. The SCR selective reduction catalyst, which converts the NOx and CO2 into valuable products. The urea is sprayed through the process of SCR working. When it is in function, SCR continuously sprays the urea solution over the fumes, which converts the fumes into HO2 and nitrogen. The HO2 is directly filtered from the SCR and sent to the reservoir. Then the nitrogen gas is directly exhausted out to the atmosphere. It does not affect the atmosphere such much. Let's see the demand for this product. in our locality, we are consuming more than 90 lakh liters per week over for automobile consumption only. So that we can able to use this as very good alternative fuel for those vehicles and industrial burners. Through this process, we can able to reduce the huge amount of plastic wastes within a 4 years. The idea can be easily implemented out. It is and it is not much complicated to be operate. It is easily developed and easily marketed out. Now we are manufacturing a mini plant from 150 kilograms to up to 10 tons, which can able to get erected within a week easily. And it is operated out from anywhere, any condition. It does not need any huge power source. It is only able to operate within a 1 kilowatt power. So we can able to operate the machineries under 1 HP motors. Now let's see the things we are used in this machine. The water used in the condenser does not directly interact with the fumes, so it can be recycled at any time and continuously used for a long term operation of these machines. It can be also used for agricultural purpose, the H2O released out from the SCR converter. Is there any questions? My dear brothers and sisters, hello. Right now we are working up with a wide kind of raw materials in this project. First of all, we have selected the plastics and then developed the fuel. Right now we are induced to develop fuel from animal fat, which is can also able to produce valuable fuels. It is under development with our own institution. And also we have used to develop the fuel from soybean also. It is very good alternative fuel for all kind of vehicles and can able to produce a good quality of fuel to operate the CI engines as well as SI engines and generators, motors, etc. சார் தங்கல் சார் சார் குட் ஆஃப்டர்நூன் சார் சார்
குட் ஆஃப்டர்நூன் ஐ அம் தங்கவேல் ஃப்ரம் மெக்கானிக்கல் டிபார்ட்மெண்ட்
சார் ஐ நோ சார்
வெதர் வி கன்வெர்ட் ஆல் த ஆல் டைப்ஸ் ஆஃப் பிளாஸ்டிக்ஸ் இன்டு ஃபியூயல்
எஸ் சார் ஐ கேன் ஏபிள் டு கன்வெர்ட் ஆல் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் பிளாஸ்டிக்ஸ் இன்டு ஃபியூயல் But the yield from the different kind of plastics is changes. Like what? HDP can able to produce up to 80% and LDP can able to produce up to 75%.
Okay.
HDP is a high density polyethylene and LDP low density polyethylene and PV, polyvinyl chloride, it can only able to produce up to 45% of fuel only. But we can able to get a carbon as yield from PVC in higher amount. It is more valuable than fuel, sir. It can be used in all kind of cement industries as additives and it can be used in chappal industries for the sole preparation.
Okay.
Sir.
Okay, thank you. One more question.
Yes, sir.
Whether the fuel damage the engine parts?
No, sir. It is not damaging. We are undergoing for a testing in our laboratory. The fuel produced from these plastics have only a minimum and a lowered concentration of carbon and sulfur content in that. It is comparatively very low from our real fuels like diesel and petroleum right now we are using.
Okay.
That's why the fuel can able to give higher mileage as well as it is reduced in the production of pollutions also.
Okay.
Sir.
Okay. Thank you, Arulmani.
Thank you, sir. Is anybody has doubt? Okay, let's see how much I invested in my company and what are all the balance sheet and how profit I earning from this business and all can be discussed. For this plant, I have invested nearly 90 lakhs for purchasing my land and my machineries and including my working capital. In this, the plastic has been purchased from 10 rupees from 10 rupees to 12 rupees range from Chennai suppliers. Right now I'm seeking for the local suppliers from Salem and Coimbatore also. The catalyst for this pyrolysis is purchased from Coimbatore. Its cost is around 18 rupees and the overall production cost for this fuel is 27.85 rupees. Right now I am selling this fuel for 36 rupees in the market. And our company's monthly production of production yield is around 120,000 liters. Hello sir, Santosh sir.
Arulmani.
Sir.
You have told about the fuel. I like to know about the properties of the fuel.
Yes,
density, etc.
Yes sir, the density of fuel is 810 kilogram per meter cube. It is comparatively,
okay.
It is comparatively lower than the traditional fuels. So
okay.
We can able to easily lubricate the engine with the fuel also, and it can
okay.
able to flow easily through the carburetor, and its
okay.
flash point is 50 degrees centigrade and the fire point is 76 degrees centigrade, and the sulfur content in this is 0.2%, which is comparatively very low. Sir?
Yes, I am hearing you.
Sir.
Yes, go ahead.
I'd like to thank our principal for giving an opportunity to organize this program. I also thank Arun Kumar, the president of IAC, for organizing this function. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank the resource persons who has done an excellent work, who has shared their experience, which was benefiting the students. So I take this opportunity to thank all our resource person, especially Mr. P. Arulmani, who has done this in an excellent way.
Thank you, Mr. Arulmani, for your excellent presentation. Any questions from the audience? Please. Right. Today we had four different sessions. Session number one dealt with Mr. Sendhil Kumar. He gave a very good presentation on testing and calibration of laboratories, obtaining NABL accreditation and other accreditations, what are all needed for a research lab or a research institute of an education institution. It gave us a very good opening on testing and calibration. And session two was handled by Mr. Perumal Jayaprakash, Managing Director of Novonet. His presentation was excellent about the herbal role of herbal medicines in pets and the importance of using herbal medicines in today's life. And third one was by my dear friend Dr. Geeta Kennedy, founder chairman of Alpha Omega, gave us a very good presentation on food quality, about the microbiological analysis, and then about their new innovative products. That is the crackers, what they have designed through herbal medicine, which is eco-friendly. Paper plate made up of herbal raw materials. And she also spoke about the bioproducts, what she is developing in her company. And finally, our alumni, Mr. Arulmani, given you a presentation, which is the need of the hour, on generating alternate fuels using waste plastics. His idea was a tremendous one, where he collected the waste plastics and worked on that in our college campus for more than 2 years. When he was studying third year, he started his work. And this gave him an idea to start a startup. And now he has got good experience as an entrepreneur. His product is about to come to the market within 6 months or a year. And our hearty wishes to him. So four different presentation by panel members. We were earlier decided to go for a panel discussion, keeping all the four members to give a lecture on a common topic, Make in India. But later on, we felt that if they share their experience individually, it will be good information for all the audience. I have to thank Mr. Sendhil Kumar, Mr. Perumal Jayaprakash, Dr. Geetha Kennedy, and Mr. Arulmani for their wonderful participation. Thanks for accepting our invitation. And I have to thank my dear colleagues, Professor Rajan and Dr. Sridevi, for their excellent coordination and organizing this program. My special thanks to President of IIC, Dr. Arun Kumar Madhavappan, and thanks to all my students and other audience for your patient listening for the entire day, that too in the weekend. Thank you, one and all. We will again meet in some other webinar sessions. Thank you very much.
Dear participants, the feedback link is available in the chat box. All of you fill the feedback and receive the certificate. Thank you.